The Islamic Creed, according to Imam Tahawi's book, commentary by Shaykh Muhammad al-Yaqoubi.
Alhamdulillahi wa kafa wa salamun ala ibadihi alladhina astafa. Alhamdulillahi alladhi hadana lihada wa ma kunna linahtadiya lawla an hadana Allah. أصلي وأسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد, dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We continue our study of the Islamic Creed as presented by al-Imam Abu Ja'far al-Tahawi in his famous epistle. قال العلامة حجة الإسلام أبو جعفر الوراق الطحاوي بمصر رحمه الله هذا ذكر بيان عقيدة أهل السنة والجماعة. أهل السنة, those who follow the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, والجماعة, the majority, the main group, those who do not deviate from. So the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum followed the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The majority of their followers followed them, and the majority of their followers followed the followers. فَالْعِلْمُ نُورٌ بثه المصطفى ورثه الصاحب للتابعي. As I said in one of my poems, knowledge is light. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم spread, the companions picked it up from him, they gave it to their followers, later on their followers gave it to their followers. These are the three generations we mentioned in an earlier lecture. These are the best generations. The great imams like Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal are followers of the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are followers of the Sahaba and the Tabi'een. Some of them are Tabi'een like Imam Abu Hanifa. Some of them are التابعين. So these are Ahlul Sunnah. Ahlul Sunnah are the majority of Muslims today, walhamdulillah. And Ahlul Jama'ah also the same. They did not deviate. You'll see, in every generation there was a sect that split from Ahlul Sunnah. Starting from the time of Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu ta'ala an, it was al-Khawarij, the deviators, who rebelled against him and split. They left the main group of Ahlul Sunnah. They left al-Jama'ah. The Mu'tazilites, they left the main body of Ahlul Sunnah. Started with Wasil ibn Ata'. He was studying with Al-Hasan al-Basri. Then he left Al-Hasan al-Basri with his own opinions and started his own circle, deviated from the opinions and of Ahlul Sunnah and differed. So he left the Jama'ah. This is why it's always a source of rightness, a source of strength, a source of a sign of salvation to be with the majority group of Muslims. That's Ahlul Sunnah. Ahlul Sunnah are the Hanafis and the Malikis, the Shafi'is and the Hanbalis. Ahlul Sunnah are the Ash'aris. Ahlul Sunnah are the Maturidis. Ahlul Sunnah are Ahlul Hadith. Ahlul Sunnah, amongst Ahlul Sunnah, we have the greatest imams from al-Tabi'een, the students of the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, the students of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and Aisha Umm al-Mu'mineen رضي الله تعالى عنهما سيدنا علي سلمان الفارسي سعد بن أبي وقاص in Al-Kufa produced the school of Al-Kufa which was summed up in the Hanafi school. So you have Abid al-Salmani, you have Al-Aswad ibn Yazid, Alqama ibn Waqqas, later on Ibrahim al-Nakha'i, later on you have Al-Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah ta'ala. In Al-Madinah al-Munawwara, you have Salim, son of Abdullah ibn Umar. You have Nafi', the freed slave of Sayyiduna Abdullah ibn Umar. You have Abu Zinad, who took from Abdul Rahman al-A'raj, the student of Abu Huraira. You see how Imam Malik followed in suit later on and adopted their opinions. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma in Mecca. You have his students, Qatada ibn Di'ama al-Sadusi. You have Ata', you have ibn Abi Ata', you have Ikrima. Those are the tabi'een. Their students later on came as Shafi'i to pick up knowledge from them. So, knowledge in Islam is inherited. And the Aqidah is inherited and has come down to us from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through the Sahaba and the Tabi'een. It is not something that Al-Imam al-Tahawi invented. It is not something that Imam Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari came up with. It is not something that Imam Abu Mansur al-Maturidi just decided to bring. The same with fiqh. The school of Imam Abu Hanifa, Shafi'i, Malik, Ahmad ibn Hanbal, they did not sit down and decided to bring a new fiqh to the Muslim Ummah. They picked up their fiqh from their teachers, who picked it up from their teachers who were either Sahaba or Tabi'een or Tabi'at-Tabi'een. They just continued teaching. And they gave fatwas on new issues which were not discussed before. So that's the Sunni way. These are Ahlul Sunnah. When you look at the school of Imam Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari, you find great masters like Abu Bakr ibn Furak, Abu Bakr ibn Tayyib al-Baqillani, Imam al-Haramain al-Juwayni, Abu Ishaq al-Isfarayini, Abu al-Qasim al-Qushayri, al-Imam Abu Hamid al-Ghazali, etc. You come down to Al-Hafidh ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, Al-Imam Shihab al-Din al-Qastallani, Al-Imam Jalal al-Din al-Suyuti. These all were Ash'aris. So Ash'aris are the hearts of Ahlul Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. Go to the school of Imam Abu Mansur al-Maturidi. All Hanafis are Maturidis. Because Imam Abu Ja'far al-Tahawi was Hanafi. And he followed in his epistle the terminology of Imam Abu Hanifa, which he used in his work Al-Fiqh Al-Akbar, we mentioned as the first book ever written in Aqidah. And later on, Imam Abu Mansur al-Maturidi was Hanafi, elaborated more on the proofs, on the way the Aqidah is presented and advocated. So you have great figures, Kamaluddin ibn al-Humam, Al-Siwasi, author of Fathul Qadir. You have Al-Imam Al-Bazdawi. You have Al-Imam Al-Bukhari, Ubaidullah ibn Mas'ud. You have Al-Imam Al-Taftazani. You have great imams who are also the core of Ahlul Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. Imam Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari himself was a great scholar of hadith, as Al-Imam Al-Qushayri pointed out, that the school of Imam Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari follows the people of al-Hadith. And of course, there are those scholars of Hadith who did not want to delve into deep studies and did not engage in the advocation against other sects, and they were just on their own, presenting the Aqidah just in simple ways. And they were known as the people of Hadith without any deviation. And we find that the people of Hadith, and the Ash'aris and the Maturidis are all one body. That is the body of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. There is no hardly any differences amongst them. There are some minor differences, but they do not actually constitute any split or schism or cause of conflict. It is on minor issues between them, but they are all on the same way of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. And any deviation from Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah is considered out of the fold of following the Salaf radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. And in this context, if we are to define the real Salafis are the Hanafis and the Shafi'is, the Malikis, and the true Hanbalis, and the Ash'aris, and the Maturidis. These are the true Salafis. If Abu Hanifa is not one of the best of the Salaf, who is then? If Imam Malik is not one of the best of the Salaf, who is then? Those are the Salaf which we follow. So it is actually, we have better right to claim the term Salafis than those who come from outside the fold of the four madhabs to claim to be Salafis. The Hanafis and the Shafi'is, the Malikis and the true Hanbalis are the real followers of the Salaf. هذا ذكر بيان عقيدة أهل السنة والجماعة على مذهب فقهاء الملة أبي حنيفة النعمان بن ثابت الكوفي وأبي يوسف يعقوب بن إبراهيم الأنصاري وأبي عبد الله محمد بن الحسن الشيباني رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين. The following is an exposition of the creed of the people of the prophetic way and the majority of scholars أهل السنة والجماعة in accordance with the understanding of Muslim jurists such as Imam Abu Hanifa, al-Nu'man ibn Thabit al-Kufi, Abu Yusuf, Ya'qub ibn Ibrahim al-Ansari, and Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn al-Hasan al-Shaybani. Now Imam Abu Hanifa is very famous. He was born near 80 of Hijrah. He died near 150. The year he died, Imam Shafi'i was born. Imam Abu Hanifa was a Tabi'i. He met some of the Sahaba, and it has been also authenticated that he narrated some hadith. His two major students are the ones mentioned here, Al-Imam Abu Yusuf, Al-Qadi known as. Imam Abu Yusuf is the main student of Imam Abu Hanifa. The second is Imam Muhammad ibn al-Hasan al-Shaybani. They are known both in the Hanafi school as As-Sahiban, the two companions. Students of scholars in early generations were not called students. They were called Ashab. Why? Because they accompanied their teachers for their lifetime. So they were in the Suhba, in the company of their teachers. Thabit al-Bunani accompanied Sayyiduna Anas for 40 years. Al-Imam Abu Hanifa accompanied his teacher for 17 years, 17. So, long time, this is why they were called Ashab. So Abu Yusuf and Muhammad, they are called As-Sahiban, the two companions. They are the two major scholars in the Hanafi school. Abu Yusuf is said to have been a mujtahid mutlaq if he opted to, if he wanted his own madhab. He would have established his own madhab, but he decided to follow Imam Abu Hanifa. And here is one thing interesting I would like to point out to. When we say madhab al-Hanafi, or al-madhab al-Shafi'i, or al-Maliki, or al-Hanbali, do we mean that this madhab is the opinion of the founder, Abu Hanifa, for example? No. We don't follow blindly one person. We don't follow as Hanafis Abu Hanifa. We don't follow as Malikis Imam Malik. We follow a school. Hundreds of scholars who followed each other for over 12 centuries studied the opinions and the fatwas of their founder and filtered what's right and what's wrong. So we're not blind followers at all. Rather, we follow because it's proven to us through generations of scholars that these opinions are valid, authentic, or stronger. This is why in the Hanafi school, there is a saying, ثُلُثُ مَذْهَبِ أَبِي حَنِيفَةَ لَيْسَ لَهُ وَإِنَّمَا لِلصَّحِبَيْنِ. One third of the Hanafi school does not belong to Abu Hanifa. It belongs to his two companions. So when you say, I follow Abu Hanifa, no, I don't follow Abu Hanifa. I follow the Hanafi school. And there's a huge difference between following Abu Hanifa and following the Hanafi school. There's a huge difference between following Imam Malik and following the Maliki school. Because scholars later on differed from Imam Malik, differed from Imam Abu Hanifa. Even a third student of Imam Abu Hanifa is called Zufar ibn al-Hudayl, elderly student. Also, his opinion is valid and is over the opinion of Imam Abu Hanifa on 17 different issues in the Hanafi madhab. This is to correct this misunderstanding that spreads amongst some people that when we follow madhab, we follow one person. No, we don't follow one person. We follow a school of thought. As-Sahiban, the two companions, Abu Yusuf and Muhammad, did not mind going against their teacher in some of his opinions. They differed from him and they had their own opinions. Later on, scholars found that the opinions of these two students of Imam Abu Hanifa are higher and stronger than the opinions and the proofs of their teacher. So this is the beauty of the way of Ahlus Sunnah. We're not blindly following one person. وما يعتقدون من أصول الدين ويدينون به رب العالمين. It includes their beliefs about the theological foundations of the religion upon which they base their worship of the Lord of the worlds. You see here the use of أصول الدين quite early. The use of أصول الدين. We mentioned that this is one of the names of this discipline. علم التوحيد, علم العقيدة, علم أصول الدين, علم الكلام. قال الإمام وبه قال الإمامان المذكوران رحمهما الله تعالى. Imam Abu Hanifa says, so does Imam Abu Yusuf and Imam Muhammad. May Allah have mercy upon them. نقول في توحيد الله معتقدين بتوفيق الله. We assert about the unity of Allah, believing with providence that. Now the paragraphs from here onward are given numbers in the translation, and we're going to use these numbers to make it easy to follow up during these lectures so that people can find the text we're studying easily. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَاحِدٌ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَلَا شَيْءَ مِثْلُهُ وَلَا شَيْءَ يُعْجِزُهُ وَلَا إِلَهَ غَيْرُهُ قَدِيمٌ بِلَا ابْتِدَاءِ دائم بلا انتهاء لا يفنى ولا يبيد ولا يكون إلا ما يريد. God is one without partner. Nothing is like him. Nothing debilitates him. No deity exists save him. He is pre-existent, without origin, eternal, without end. He neither perishes nor ceases to exist. Nothing will be except what he wills. Now, these are seven paragraphs, but every paragraph actually highlights one of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which obliges us to elaborate on these attributes and mention them. Later scholars specified these attributes and that are necessary. يجب لله تعالى. It is necessary that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أن يتصف بصفات الكمال, with all attributes of perfection. These attributes are summed up in one attribute known as الصفة النفسية, the essential attribute, existence, الوجود. Five negating الصفات السلبية, القدم, البقاء, المخالفة للحوادث, فواجب له الوجود والقدم, كذا بقاء لا يشاب بالعدم, وأنه لما ينال العدم مخالف برهان هذا القدم قيامه بالنفس وحدانية. Five attributes: البقاء, القدم, المخالفة للحوادث, القيام بالنفس, الوحدانية, known as the negating attributes. And then we have seven attributes known as الصفات المعاني, وقدرة, إرادة, وغايرت, أمرا, وعلما, والرضا كما ثبت, وعلمه ولا يقال مكتسب, فاتبع سبيل الحق واطرح الرياب, حياته كذا الكلام السمع, ثم البصر بذي أتانا السمع. القدرة, الإرادة, الحياة, العلم, السمع, البصر, الكلام. Seven attributes are known as الصفات المعاني. Following الصفات المعاني, there are seven attributes known as الصفات المعنوية: كونه قادرا, كونه مريدا, كونه عالما, كونه حيا, كونه سميعا, كونه بصيرا, كونه متكلما. So the attributes in total are 20. These are the main attributes to which every other attribute refers or is included under. So we're going to detail these in the next lecture, inshallah. I just wanted to highlight the main attributes and how later scholars classified them. الصفة النفسية, essential. الصفات السلبية, negating attributes. الصفات المعاني, attributes with meanings. And الصفات المعنوية, being so, derived from the meanings of the seven attributes. So these are 20 in total, and the details of these attributes will follow, inshallah, in the coming lecture and lectures, actually, because this is going to take a few hours and few lessons, inshallah. Barakallahu feekum. Allah bless you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.